So alkenes. So these alkenes are unsaturated hydrocarbon. Unsaturated hydrocarbon. But in between the carbon, double bond is present. So in between the carbons, a double bond is present. Such compounds are called as alkenes. These alkenes are unsaturated hydrocarbons. Generally, alkenes are undergoes sp2 hybridization. So alkenes are participated in sp2 hybridization, whereas alkenes are participated in sp3 hybridization. So these alkenes undergo sp2 hybridization. This sp2 hybridization bond angle is 120 degrees. Next, these alkenes, generally the alkenes are containing one pi bond. So one pi bond is present. Okay, in alkenes one pi bond is present. Due to the presence of pi bond, these alkenes are unstable. So the alkenes are unstable compared to alkanes. So alkanes are stable molecule because these alkanes are contained in between the carbon, single bond is present, here double bond is present. This double bond is pi bond, this is your sigma bond. So the breakage of this sigma bond required more energy, but this is your weaker bond, this is your strong bond. Okay, so due to that alkenes are unstable, but alkanes are stable. Next one, alkenes. So IUPAC nomenclature of alkenes. IUPAC nomenclature of alkenes. So generally alkenes, here primary suffix is ene. And next, here root word, according to root word, depending upon their parent carbon, meth, eth, propo, you use like that. So now, for example, if you write CH3, CH double bond, CH2. So in that, first give the numbering to less number to double bond. So here 1, 2, 3. Or if you write a numbering like this, 1, 2, 3. So in this case, so this carbon, the double bond getting 2. But in this case, your double bond getting 1. So the always double bond getting a very less number. So for this one, what is the name of this one? Your 3 carbons are there. 3 carbon means your root word is prop. Your double bond is present, that is in propene. But this is which type of propene? According to first one, this is 1 propene. According to first numbering, this is 1 propene, next one is 2 propene. But in these two, only one naming is correct. So according to this second priority order is wrong, this priority order is correct. So this IUPAC nomenclature is 1 propene but not 2 propene, because it gives the less number to double bond. For example, this is our example 1, example 2, for example this one. So this is our first alkene. Okay, the first alkene is this one. So here 2 carbons are there. 2 carbon means if you give the numbering in any directions, it getting the numbering is same. So here how many carbons are there? 2 carbons. 2 carbon means eth. Here primary suffix is ene, ethene. Okay, like that. Now if you consider another example, CH3, CH double bond, CH2, CH3. In this, so give the first numbering and select a longest carbon chain. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is one numbering. In this order here, second carbon, the double bond getting 2. From this manner, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In any manner, the longest chain is containing 5 carbons. In this, the first numbering is correct because here double bond getting second numbering. In this manner, the double bond getting third. So this numbering is wrong. So according to this, here how many carbons are there? Total 5 carbons are present. So 5 carbon means its root word is pent. Here double bond means that is your pentene. This is which type of pentene? 2 pentene. This name is 2-pentene. And not only this one, because if you observe for symmetrical alkene, so symmetrical alkene, so this is your symmetrical alkene. CH3, CH double bond, CH, CH3. Okay, the plane is passed through a double bond. It gives two identical parts, two identical atoms or identical groups. So that is called as symmetrical alkene. This is your symmetrical alkene. In this symmetrical alkene, if you give the numbering 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. This which type of alkene? Your 4 carbons are there, that is your 2-butene. Okay, this is your symmetrical alkene. Now, if you consider unsymmetrical alkene, this is your unsymmetrical alkene. Now, your simple example CH3, CH double bond CH3 or CH2. So, 2 plus 2, that valency is 4, the valency is satisfied. Now, the plane is passed through a double bond. Whenever the plane is passed through a double bond, here identical parts or identical atoms or identical molecules are not same. There is no identical atoms. So due to that, okay, this is called as unsymmetrical alkene. This is your symmetrical alkene. In any alkene, what is the numbering here? 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So what is the name of this one? 1-propene. So this what naming is 1-propene. So this is your IUPAC nomenclature of alkene. And next one, generally the alkane general formula, the alkane general formula is CnH2n+2. Now alkene, so double bond, that general formula is CnH2n. Okay, the alkene general formula is CnH2n. Now applied, for example, if it is, whenever the applying of C1 carbon, it getting, what is your one? C1 into 2 into 1, that is H2, CH2. C1H2 means the first alkene is this one. This is your first alkene. What is your first alkene? C2H4, that is your ethene. This is your first alkene. The first alkene is ethene, that is your CH2 double bond CH2. Now, this alkene, here, you know, the difference is how much here? CH2 unit is increases. Every time CH2 unit is increases here, for example, C3 carbon. If it is 3 carbons are present, what happened? C3H, 2 into 3, that is 6. Again, CH2 unit is increases. This is propene. Okay, like that. So means the alkene general formula is CnH2n. Every time CH2 unit is increases. And next one, these alkenes, now the alkenes are generally, representation is 2 types. We already discussed that one. So alkenes are 2 types. One is symmetrical alkene and unsymmetrical alkene. Symmetrical alkene means the plane is passed through a double bond, it appears as identical atoms, is called as symmetrical alkene. Whenever the plane is passed through a double bond, it appears non-identical atoms, so that is called as unsymmetrical alkene. So the symmetrical and unsymmetrical alkenes behavior we discuss later. Now in this alkene, generally we represent ethylene. So this is our ethylene molecule, C2H4. So this is your C2H4. So in this is your sigma bond. This is your pi bond. One pi bond, one sigma bond is present. Now, due to the presence of pi bond, it involving in PP overlapping. So due to PP overlapping, these alkenes are easily reactable. So because these are the unstable molecules, so the alkenes are easily attackable on a suitable reagent. So these are easily forms electrophile. These are involving in electrophilic reagent. So generally all alkenes are involving in electrophilic substitution reaction because electrophilic center is present. See here. So this is your electrophilic center. For example, this bond is cleavage here. It converted to like this. C bond C. Here this arrow mark containing a negative charge, here attached to positive charge. So means the alkenes are participated in electrophilic reaction, especially electrophilic addition reaction. And next one, whereas alkenes are involving in substitution reaction, we discussed, already completed the topic.